So you also have functions that work with text, and we haven't seen that yet. So, and the one that you have to use very regularly is the paste function. What does it do? It pastes two pieces of text, so it glues them together. I will show you how it works. So this is the first piece of text. This is the second piece of text. You want to make one big piece of text of that, so it's kind of merging, but now with text. How do you do it? You use the paste function. The first argument is the first piece of text that you want to paste. The second argument is the second piece of text that you want to paste. So this will generate p equals 0.01. Which is something that you often want to include. So what is annoying here, or annoying, something that you have to know, is that when you give him two pieces of text that you want to combine, he will automatically put an empty space in between the two pieces of text. That's his default behavior. I can show you. When we take a look at the documentation of paste, it's a simple function. So you simply give it character input. It can be multiple, even more than two, and it will paste all these pieces of text together. There is here one argument called sep, the separator. So what he puts in between these pieces of text. And you see that by default, that's an empty string. So this is why he always puts this blank space in between the pieces of text that he merges. So if you want to change that, you have to specify this argument and set separator, sep, equal to an empty string. That's what you do here. So when you do it now, the paste, it has disappeared. Okay, when do you typically use the pasting? When you want to make titles or text that you want to put on a figure. So P is equal to a value is typically something that you want to put on your bar chart to indicate that there are groups that are significantly different.